Hello, O'Hare. What do you know?
Not a thing. That lug tells his wife everything he knows. I should tell him anything.
Good morning, Mr. O'Hare.
Oh, good morning, Mrs. Scroggins. How's Mr. Scroggins?
He's not so well this morning.
Oh, that's unfortunate. I'm sorry to hear that.
I'm worried about him.
Yeah, I am, too. Guess he's out on one of his benders last night again. Boy, how can he even drink that raw alcohol and live? I don't know. Fine mare he is.
Get out of here.
I think all I gotta do all day long is paint that pole.
Pop, Mom says for you to come up and get your fiddles right away.
Get my fiddles? I'll be right with you, Ronald.
Sit down and eat your dinner.
Want no meat?
Vegetables contain more mineral.
Pop, you want to hear another cat riddle?
Yes, I would, Ronald. I'd love to.
What looks most like a cat? Looking out of a window.
I don't know. What looks most like the domestic feline contentedly gazing from the window?
I'll tell you, Pop, what looks most like a cat looking out of a window. Another cat looking in.
Oh, very good, Ronald. Very good. Eat your spinach.
Pop, would you like to hear another riddle?
Don't encourage him. Eat your carrots.
Why, dear, that shows he's awfully smart. Mr. Lincoln used to tell riddles, and that, as much as anything else, made him the wonderful president that he was.
Huh?
Coming. Hey, all you!
Coming. I'm coming.
Hello, boys. I hear you want to buy a fiddle.
Oh, no. I have Lena here. I'm perfectly satisfied with her.
Oh, but him is a fine fiddle.
He may be a fine fiddle, but I get very sweet music out of Lena.
And somebody told me that you want to buy a fiddle.
Well, as a matter of fact, a few weeks ago I did, but I had Lena all fixed up, and I'm perfectly satisfied with her now.
And me push him for 3 miles.
Oh, I'm sorry about that.
Hey, boy, can I keep him here till I come back from work?
Oh, surely. Put him right in the corner here.
That's fine,
Harry. Put him right in there. That's okay.
Yeah.
That's fine.
You'll take good care of him, eh?
I'll take good care of him, yes.
Hello, boys.
Goodbye.
Roger Malnard,
or whatever it is. How do you do, Horton? Miss Sharon. Have a nice lunch?
Yes. I had a wonderful steak at the lunch counter.
Steak? I love meat. But we never have it at our house. My wife's a vegetarian. All we have is vegetables. How do you do, sir? Can you sit down?
Manicure?
No.
Haircut or shave?
Yeah.
I beg your pardon. Isn't your name Flug?
Yeah.
I thought so. I didn't recognize your face when you first came in.
No, it's all healed up since I was in here last.
Well, Mr. O'Hare, I see they're offering $2,000 reward for that bandit who robbed the bank at Cocomonga City.
$2,000? I'd like to get that, though. If I wasn't so busy, I'd go over and choke that guy to death. I'd teach him not to rob banks in and around Merton City.
Oh, Mr. O'Hare. Did you know you had your hat on backwards?
Oh, I beg your pardon?
Did you know you had your hat on backwards?
Oh, no. Oh, thank you very much. I had it on backwards day before yesterday, and a friend of mine came up and kicked me in the stomach. Dropping.
Hey, Joe, don't get me! Hold it!
Dropping. Kittles. Be careful, boys, be careful.
Get out of here, Mr. O'Hare.
I haven't thrown a spitball since I was first-line pitcher on the Baltimore Orioles years ago. Oh, son! Get on the other side of the street.
Okay.
There she goes. Ow. Well, he didn't hit it. Dropping. Shut your eyes, please.
down, da 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 da.
That tickle?
Mm-hmm.
A little in your ears there, but that won't hurt, huh?
Probably won't. Da 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 da.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Is it true that you can take weight off in that steam room of yours?
I positively guarantee it.
My wife says if I don't get some of this fat off of me, she'll leave me.
Just step right this way, will you? Right in here.
Here's the room right here.
Just go into this hangar. Change your clothes in there. If he ever took his shoes off, he'd go right up in the air.
Hey, what's that dog doing in here?
Oh, it's a very funny thing. The other day, a man was in here, and I was shaving him. The razor slipped, and I cut his ear off. The dog got it. Ever since, he's been hanging around here for... Go away, go away, go away. He's going to get another... He can't get another... Ah, there you are. Here we are. Here's the steam room. Right in there. Right in there and sit down. And I'll turn the steam on right away. Come on, Ethel, get excited. There you are. Now, don't stay in here over a minute. See, and if it gets too hot, just press that button and the light will go on. And if you get in any trouble, just pull that rope and the horn will blow up there, and I'll get you right out. I won't be long.
Stays in there a minute, it'll take a ton off him.
Just one little hot towel and we'll be right through with you.
Like an old fire horse. Want to get back in the harness again. I used to be a detective once.
Really, Mr. O'Hare?
Yes, yes.
You seem to have been everything.
I guess I was. My wife calls me everything. Yes, yes, my will-o'-the-wisp.
Did you mail that letter I gave you yesterday morning?
Yes, I did, dear, yes.
I think I'm going to have my dress
yes,
fitted.
Yes, yes, go ahead, yes, have your dress fitted, yes. How do you do, Mrs. Broadbottom?
How do you do, Mr. O'Hare?
Fine, thank you.
Would you mind taking care of the baby while I go into the drugstore?
I'd love to. I'd love to.
Thank you.
How's Mr. Broadbottom?
Fine, thank you. I'll be just a minute.
Okay. Hey, what's this? What's here? Come here. Come here. My little woolly britches. Don't you know to swallow a thing like that would kill you? I'll get it. Here she is. Oh.
Wouldn't you like to wait for a little powder?
I'd like to have enough powder to blow you to precision, seeing the nose.
Have you had enough?
Have I had enough?
I've been biting your nails again, eh?
If I had my former weight,
I'd choke you to death.
Oh.
I'll sue you and take this barber shop away from you.
Oh, well, I don't care. And I've just had this nice new steam room put in, too.
I'll have the law on you for this.
Oh.
O'Hare. If
yes,
you
sir?
Think you've heard the last of this, you're mistaken.
Mm-hmm.
You deliberately locked me in that room.
Why, that's a colossal fib. I'm a very kind-hearted person. I've never hurt man, beast, or child. Except when I had to. Northwest. I belong to the Bare Hand Wolf Chokers Association. Had to choke a wolf to death before you could belong to the social. Up there. Yes, sir.
Listen, Barbara. Get rid of those people.
Yeah?
And get rid of them quick.
I will. Yeah, all right.
Now, I'm sorry, folks. There's a gentleman ahead of you.
That's absurd. After I've waited here this length of time.
He telephoned in. He telephoned.
Say, what's the matter with you?
He was here. He came.
You act like an idiot. I'll tell you that.
Come on, sorry.
Gloria. We'll get out of this place.
I'll go upstairs in just a minute.
Stay where you are.
Yes, sir.
Listen, Barbara.
Yes, sir.
You've got just 10 minutes to make me look like another man.
Yes, sir.
I got to get out of this town. I got to get out fast.
Mm-hmm.
Get that thing off there.
Yes, sir.
Come on, now. Make it snappy.
I think I'll go home, Mr. O'Hare.
Stay where you are. Listen, Barbara, get this. Take the mustache off. Take the tabs off. Take the eyebrows off. Close crop the hair. And make it snappy.
Well, have you tried that good barber down at the hotel? He's wonderful.
Get busy.
I'm the worst barber in town. My wife will tell you that, won't she?
Would you take those off?
Yes, sir.
What are you doing? Are you going to get going or are you going to get going?
I'm going to get going. Lock the door, Miss Sharp. Gangway, please.
Stop in the name of the law. In the name of the law!
Get out of the way, you fool!
Ah! Yeah. Let me out! I didn't try to get you! I like bandits! Some of my best friends are bandits! The president of the bank comes up to our house!
Congratulations, Mr. O'Hare!
Huh?
You get the 2,000 reward! This is the fellow we've been looking for!
Yeah, I know him. I told you I'd get him, didn't
I? What's the matter here? What happened? Well, what happened?
The bandit. I caught the bandit.
You caught him?
Yeah, I got the $2,000 reward. I had to chase him around the block 3 times before I got the revolver away from him.
I don't believe my own ears.
Here, one time, folks. Just a minute. Here's the brave little lad that captured the bandit. He hit a liner with a baseball that struck him right on the top of the head. He knocked poor Mr. O'Hare here off his bicycle. Are you hurt, Mr. O'Hare?
Not physically, no.
Here, come on, Dick. Get these folks out of here. Come on, please.
All right, come on, you.
That's a brave little lad, Ronald. As regards to the reward, Mr. O'Hare, if you'll step over to the station tomorrow, I'll see that you get it.
So you caught the burglar. Come, Ronald.
Huh? Do you want to hear another riddle?
Not now, Ronald. Not now. I'm not in the mood. Go upstairs and eat your spinach.
Never mind, Mr. O'Hare. I know you caught the bandit.
I know I caught him, too. What's the good of arguing with those people? They're all nervous. You can't talk to them at all. Come on, Lena. Let's go to her.
Lena!
Devils are just as lively as can be, too.
Lena, how could you?